Undisputed. I'm Jenny Taff with Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp. I'm ready to go today. How are you guys doing?
I'm good, Jenny. Glad to see you in such a festive mood. Somebody else, not so much, because he's about to get beat down for way up in Bel Air.
Oh, really? Well, guess what? We're going to start this show by handing Shannon Sharp a silver platter topic. Christian McCaffrey is the son of Ed McCaffrey, Shannon's longtime teammate in Denver. And Shannon watched little Christian grow up around the locker room with the Broncos. And I'm still predicting he will lose this debate. Watch.
There's zero chance.
All right. Skip, you know, what a way to start.
Oh, Jenny, before you go, Skip, just for you, I'm going to come down from Bel Air and play nice. And then I'm going to go back up to my palatial estate and be back to my normal self.
I'm scared.
You're going to play nice, Shannon. Okay. That'll be a first for all of us. But yes, Skip mentioned it. You do have a relationship with Christian McCaffrey. But that doesn't help you here. We're going to talk about everything with the latest. We got to start with the NFL because, guys, we've got a running back who is going to cash in. Last season, Christian McCaffrey had the third most yards from scrimmage in NFL history. And now he and the Panthers have agreed to a four-year contract extension, making him the highest paid running back in NFL history, averaging $16 million a year. Shannon, only appropriate, I ask you first, will Christian McCaffrey live up to this new deal?
Yeah. Skip, the way I look at it like this, he's exceeded expectations of what people thought he would be because most people thought he was too small to run between the tackles. And predominantly, that's where he runs. Now, he does have ability and elusiveness to get outside. He's a home run threat. He's tremendous in the receiving game. But, Skip, if you watched him in college, you could tell that he could hold up because that Stanford offense is a pro-style offense, and they run between the tackles. That's the exact same offense that Andrew Luck played in, which made him so palatable because, what, it's a pro-style offense. He takes the snap up under the center. So he was prototypical. Christian McCaffrey is everything you would want in a running back. Yeah, sure, you'd like for him to be 220. But what can't he do at 205, 207 that a 220 does? He can run the ball with power. He has escapability. He can catch the ball out of the backfield. Skip, when you perform as well as this young man has, and you're not rewarded with a long-term deal, there's something seriously wrong with the system. There's something also wrong with the system, Skip, is that every time, you know, running back comes time to get drafted, the running back's devalued. It comes time for him to get paid. The running back's devalued. Not one time did I hear in the playoff did someone say, Derrick Henry's devalued. When Christian McCaffrey is going for two bills in scrimmage yards, not one time did I say he was devalued. Only when it's coming into the draft or it's time to get paid is the running back devalued. The guy has outperformed that contract. Reward him. The thing that I'm surprised, let me take that back. I'm just glad he didn't have to do like so many other players, threaten to hold out, sit out the Aaron Donalds, the Khalil Mack, the Zeke Elliott, the guy, the Jets, Skip, I forget his name, for the Jets, the running back from the Steelers, Le'Veon Bell. They have to threaten to hold out, or Le'Veon, or actually hold out. Carolina says, bruh, you've been everything. And what choice do they really have now, Skip? No Cam, no Luke Kuechly. He was their best player on the roster last year. He's their best player now, so you got to have a start. Teddy Bridgewater, we'll see. But Teddy Bridgewater is not more popular, is not more valuable than Christian McCaffrey, so they rewarded their star player, as they should.
Shannon Sharp, I know how much you love this young man. I know how much I started loving this young man when we had him on the show in Miami on South Beach at this last Super Bowl because he is a stud of a young man. He is high class, high character, extreme intangibles. Just on intangibles alone, I would put him on a Hall of Fame arc. I loved how he carried himself. I loved how mature he was. I loved his perspective. He is everything I would want as the centerpiece of my locker room. And the one thing I loved about what the new coach Matt Rhule said was, he's what we want to rebuild our culture around. He is the new centerpiece, said Matt Rhule, of everything they want to become as a franchise. That could be a kind of between the lines, under the line shot at Cam Newton, who was never the greatest leader for that locker room. Obviously, Cam is a much better, to me, a much better player as a quarterback than Christian will ever be as a running back. But I'm just talking about the intangible impact of how hard this young man works, how hard he plays, how much he does for your offense. All that is A plus, A plus, A plus. Now we get back to what you just mentioned. He is still 200 pounds. They are 200 of the in-shapest pounds you will ever find in the National Football League. Nobody's going to work harder or stay fitter than Christian does at 200 pounds. But my gut tells me, and history is screaming at you, he will not be worth this contract. This contract could pay him as much as $75 million over the next 6 years. And Shannon, I'm going to knock on wood over here on my little desk way down here in the flats. I'm looking way up you up there in Beverly Hills in your palatial, I mean, in Bel Air, your palatial estate. But I'm knocking on wood down here in my humble abode for Christian McCaffrey, hoping he can endure the beating he is going to take. Because they are going to build their whole offense on the field around this young man. And Shannon, I don't think he can take the pounding. And you brought up Stanford his last year. The one reservation I had on him was he stayed hurt his last year at Stanford. He got pounded. He got beat up. They are a running. They're much more of a running football team than the Panthers will ever think about being. And Christian couldn't quite take that beating at Stanford. He ran 4.4 in the 40, which is not 4.2, but it's very fast for 200-pounder. He has not good hands. He has very good hands. So he does catch the ball. And the other thing that I did like that Matt Rhule said was that it's disrespectful to Christian to call him a running back. Matt Rhule said he's a tailback slash wideout. And I will give you that, tailback slash wideout. But that young man, tailback slash wideout, do you realize how many touches he had last year? He led the NFL by far in touches, Shannon, with 403. That was 48 more than next on the list, which was my man, Ezekiel Elliott. So 48 more times he either caught or carried the football and got hit. I mean, I guess sometimes he scored a touchdown and maybe he didn't get hit, but most of those times he got hit, and many of those times he got hit hard. History tells you you can't take that kind of pounding, because what happened to my man Zeke last year? Over the last 4 years, he's led the NFL in touches, catches, and carries, mostly carries on Zeke's part. But Shannon, my man Zeke, he looked like he was running in Cabo San last year after he held out in Cabo San Lucas, came back, got his money, and then I couldn't really recognize him. He didn't look like the same Zeke. He finished fourth in rushing in a league that he has won the rushing title in two of the previous 3 years and led in yards per game three of the previous 3 years. And all of a sudden, I'm looking at his yards per game, and Shannon, they're falling and falling. From his rookie year, he went 109 a game, then 98 a game, then 96 a game, then 85 a game last year, down, down, down. Pounded, pounded, pounded. And it's looking like Zeke just might not live up to the money Jerry gave him, which is now the second best money in the league to Christian. But to me, if you're extending Christian out 6 years, I'm sorry. I don't see how that smaller man can take the beating that Zeke has failed to take last year. Zeke goes 6 feet, 225. So he weighs 25 more pounds than Christian does. Does he take more pounding? Is he more of a high contact? Yeah, I'll give you that. But Shannon, in the end, as much as I'm going to root for the young man as a young man, as you do, I'm sorry. I think this was a bad idea.
Well, Skip, when you look at it, it is a little concerning because normally when a guy starts getting around 380 to 400 touches in a season, that's normally the point of no return. But I think what guys do now, Skip, in the old days, guys would get that many carries during the season, but they were practicing Wednesdays and Thursdays. They were doing more contact. I don't think that's the case in today's game, Skip. I would be surprised if Christian McCaffrey ever practices on a Wednesday, considering the amount of carries that he get during the game. Because remember, Skip, he plays 90% of the snaps. It's not like, you know, they have a back for third down and a back, you know, a short yardage back for this. He's the back. So short yardage, he's getting the ball. Third down, they're throwing him the ball. Second down, he's on the field. So he's an every down back. But I love what Matt Rhule said. This is what, when they want to reward you, they says, don't list him as a running back, and rightfully so, he's also a receiver. Le'Veon Bell tried to get that. They said, Le'Veon, get out of here. You crazy. Dude. Even though the guy had like 80-something catches, Le'Veon, you a running back. That's all you do is just run the ball, yada, yada, yada. Skip, is that my thing is this. When a guy performs, you can't look at it because you're not thinking about that. Well, he in 6 years from now, he might not be this. You're giving him the ball. He's earning that payday at some point in time. Because, Skip, we look at these contracts that some of these quarterbacks got. Are they going to be worth the money that they're getting at the end of 6 years? Or some of these defensive players, are they going to be worth that money? No, you can't look at it like he might not be worth it. You reward the guy for his play right now. Christian McCaffrey has earned this huge payday. And, Skip, when you look at it, Skip, the deal kicks in after his rookie deal. You mentioned it's basically...